video. Yeah.
So weird how as soon as you jump into your own bed, the energy of your bed just takes over you and just convinces you that you are dead tired and that you just wanna crash. Like that. Hey everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Sabrina Matti. I'm here to record a proper introduction to this channel. I have been meaning to do this for a while now. I don't know why I have kept putting it off for some reason in my head. I was just saying that it has to be a certain way or something, or has to look a certain way. And since it is 2018 now, and you know, everyone is fresh with their New Year's resolutions or their goals, I've been listening to a lot of inspirational talks and YouTubers on YouTube talking about their goals and some, I don't know, inspirational, motivational quotes or books or new things that they want to incorporate in their life. Self-improvement, y'all. Where was I getting at? I pushed myself to just tell myself, just do it. Like, what are you waiting for? Like, just do what you can do with what you have right now. I don't have any fancy like setup to record. I am living somewhere temporary. I'm living in the house I have lived in all my life. In the room that I have lived in all my life. Which is really weird if you really think about it. So I just decided, why not just do it in the comfort of my own bed? So let's get on with this, shall we? My mind has been flooding with ideas at work while I'm listening to a lot of inspirational, motivational stuff on YouTube and podcasts and such. And I have, for the past few days since I've been back at work, I have been getting antsy and anxious to just write all these ideas down as soon as they come to mind. And I hope this video doesn't end up being long, but you know what? It's the intro video to get to know me and to get to know what to expect out of this channel, so just go along with it. This is Mr. Meeseeks, by the way, before I just like do an entire video without introducing him. A little bit about me to start off. I'm turning 26. All my childhood, I have always been an artist, and I have been an artist in multitude of ways. I feel like every artist is ways where they do have talents in a lot of areas, and if they just tapped into it, like, it just flows. I am your traditional, like, actual drawing artist. I have grown up with the love of cartoons, video games. I was heavy influenced by all of that, and I loved, absolutely loved drawing cartoons and all my favorite characters and such, and creating my own characters, you know, your OCs. Growing up, everybody always told me, family, teachers, friends, everybody, they always told me that I was very good at it, and I just had this idea that this was going to be something that I was going to pursue my entire life. And I remember telling myself when I was in kindergarten that I just wanted to draw cartoons. I wanted to create cartoons. I wanted to work in that industry. Since I was pretty known to be good at it, growing up, I was always the best artist in either my school or my class. Or my grade. People always ask me to do drawings for them. I drew a lot for myself. Art classes were always my favorite because it was my little chance to shine. You know, when you grow up, you always want to have something that you can be really good at, so you can have that little self-confidence booster, because when you're a kid, you have none of that and you get bullied a lot. Unless you were one of those who were just never bullied and you did the bullying. I'm pretty sure everybody has been bullied at least once in their life. Why am I rambling? Anyways, art has always just been my thing. I graduated a year early from high school because I could not take school anymore. I always would get straight A's in all my classes. classes. I felt high school was just basically like a repeat of middle school, and it was easier than middle school for some reason. I went to a really tough middle school. It was a highly gifted magnet middle school. So high school, I just felt super pointless to me. I started getting really angry at the high school that I went to, and I just wanted the hell out, and I just wanted to get my life started. So I graduated a year early with this special certificate program. If you're interested in hearing a story about that, let me know down below. Maybe I'll do a video on that. I don't know. So I graduated after 11th grade. Didn't care about my whole senior year bullshit. Kim Kiss on YouTube. Come college time, I was already young, leaving high school and getting ready to go to college. I didn't want to do the traditional route that everybody had where they go to community college, you know, do all their general education stuff, prereqs, whatever, and then transfer to university. I didn't give a crap about all that because all I wanted to do was, I knew what I wanted to do. A lot of people didn't know what they wanted to do. I just wanted to draw. And I wanted to get that started. And I remember when I went to community college, they were telling me that I couldn't take art classes until I took like all these math classes, all these history classes, all these English classes, like all these just stupid classes that I've just been taking all my life. And I was just like, this is so, I don't understand the point of this. Like, A, I don't understand how people retain that information. B, how is it actually applicable to my life? You know, like I was already getting straight A's and throughout my entire academic, whatever, education, whatever. So I was like, why am I doing this all over again? This is so annoying. Like, I'm not, statistics, what is statistics gonna do for me in the future? I'm not gonna be like some sort of marketing or accounting or business manager person. I'm gonna be an artist. You know, I should be taking art classes by now. And I already regretted that I didn't do enough of that in high school or go to a special high school for that. So I was like, I just gotta get started on this. So my mom and I looked into special art schools, art colleges, where that's all I would be doing is just art, and then a little bit of general ed. And biggest mistake I feel like I've ever made, or I regret, the only regret I have pretty much is I didn't dive too much into what was really out there. I just searched on Google the best art schools, and of course the ones that spend the most money to get their ads seen first was seen on Google first, which was the Art Institute. So I went to the Art Institute of California Hollywood, North Hollywood, and I went there for three and a half years, and I got my bachelor's degree in media arts and animation. I don't highly recommend the art institutes. I think they're now a non-profit. I think they switched over, but like back then, I don't know, I'm just bitter because we were the guinea pigs of our program. It was very new, and even the staff, like the teachers themselves, they hated the system over there. Like, just when a school is ran by a corporation that's just money hungry, like just the energy of that, surrounding that, it's just no bueno, you know? So I got my bachelor's degree in animation, and luckily I was one of those students that I was always driven to go and achieve my goals, or I was always the go-getter. So before I even graduated, I was lucky enough to intern at Cartoon Network for Adventure Time in the year 2012. That was how I got my foot officially in the door, and I'm so blessed that I got that internship. And I do pat myself on the back for applying in the first place and doing that effort of like applying, you know, getting your resume and cover letter together, because it does take confidence and, you know, some intelligence to do that. And a lot of people just don't do it. Like, that's, I always tell people, just do it. Like, you're never, forget about, you know, like, whether you're gonna get it or not. The fact that you're just doing it is already making your chances higher of getting something like that, or an opportunity like that. So, I interned with Adventure Time, and I created such good connections with the production of Adventure Time that the coordinators and the production assistant, the production in general, on a whole, they recommended me to Cartoon Network for a round of interviews after that quarter. I interviewed to become a production assistant. I interviewed for Clarence, I interviewed for Steven Universe, and I interviewed for Uncle Grandpa. Those were the new shows at the time. I wanted to become a production assistant because I just wanted to get my foot in the door and I wanted to get a job. And I actually had high confidence in production because since the school that I went to was very tech savvy and I'm a very organized person, it's not in this video, I felt like production came really easy to me, and connecting with people via production was always the best, because you get to communicate with everybody. You get to communicate with everybody, you know, on the supervising and art directing side. And then you also get to communicate with the voice acting side. You also get to communicate with the studio on a whole, if you run errands and stuff for the production. And you communicate with every artist on the crew. So I thought that was the best foot in. And Cartoon Network was awesome enough to actually care about production assistants and what they... Sorry, am I bothering you? So they actually gave a crap about production assistants and what they wanted to do in their future. They knew that a lot of production assistants were artists and wanted to pursue that eventually. And luckily they weren't, you know, some studios, they don't like to hire artists as production people because they don't want that jump to happen, or they don't want that risk of losing them or whatever. So Cartoon Network is very sweet for doing that. I managed to get a job on Uncle Grandpa as a digital production assistant right after the internship, which was awesome, and I hadn't even graduated yet. So I was already working at the age of 20, 21, and I had my first job before I graduated, and it was awesome. And I was so blessed to have that opportunity, and it got things going for sure. So my dream career started. I was in production working at the studio of my dreams. I've always wanted to work at Cartoon Network. Cartoon Network was created on the year I was born, 1992, hey! It got to a point where I was a little scared and I didn't know if I was on the right path because I was having a difficult time making that jump or getting recognized as an artist over there. Until I had to force myself to draw every day. It was a struggle because when you have a full-time job and, you know, you lose that energy to do anything that you want to do in your spare time. You know, your personal projects. So, I managed to be consistent as much as I could with drawing and keeping up my personal artwork. And also continuing my education at Concept Design Academy. I love that school. It was great to brush up on my skills. And luckily I had people and Uncle Grandpa mentor me. Thank you, shout out to Bill Flores. He was an art director on Uncle Grandpa. He mentored me and tested me for backgrounds. They liked my backgrounds enough to hire me as a freelance background designer so I could do freelance on the side for them, on the side of my production job. So I did that, and then Rick and Morty came around. First season was already done and they were hiring for season 2, I believe, yes. And I was just getting tests from anything that I could get, and then also Rick and Morty, I had couple connections on Uncle Grandpa to Rick and Morty, so I just decided, like, hey, let's get a test and let's, you know, take a shot at it and see where it goes. That's basically what you just need to do, is just get tests and just do it. So I did a character design test. Unfortunately, I didn't get the character design position, but they liked my cleanup work so much, like the rendering and my turnarounds so much, that they asked me to be their design cleanup artist for season 2. And that is where my artist career took off. So I left Uncle Grandpa, loved them to death, missed them to death. The job was amazing, taught me so much, and boosted my confidence in knowing the ropes of animation and what goes into a pipeline, a TV show. And I became a design cleanup artist on Rick and Morty. If you want to know more about that, what my job consisted of, I can do story time or whatever on that later. Just comment down below what you want to hear more of. I'm rambling. Wow, I'm telling my whole entire life story. I'm sorry, this ends up being really long. I might cut it up into two parts. Maybe this is the intro about me, and then I'll cut it up. You know, this is the intro about me. So I got my job on Rick and Morty. After Rick and Morty, since we were under Starburns in the very beginning of season 2, I had connection with all Starburns people, and basically all of us kind of migrated from show to show after that. Starburns had a few projects going, and they basically just took people from Rick and Morty, and then just, you know, some people from Rick and Morty left to other studios, but I stayed at Starburns, and I landed on HBO Animals, and I, after that, moved on to Harmon Quest, and then from Harmon Quest I moved back on to Rick and Morty season 3, and I was a design cleanup artist again for season 3. After Rick and Morty was over, that was the first time that I personally decided not to go back to Starburns, and wanted to branch out and find something new, or aim for a different position, or work with a different environment of people. I feel like it's healthy to change up your life a bit, because when you're with those people for so long, you know, you want to branch out your networking skills or your networks. You want to get to know more people in the industry, so it's just important to make those connections and meet new people and have new experiences with these people, have new relationships. So I decided to try to maybe go back to Cartoon Network as an artist, or apply to other studios. Luckily, a couple Rick and Morty people moved onto a Rough Draft project, which I am currently on now. It's Matt Groening's new show called Disenchantment. I am super excited to be on it and also see a couple familiar faces and meet new people and be part of a completely new studio and have a new studio experience. And this studio is awesome. It's feeling like a family already. On this show, I am a cleanup artist. I decided to take a step back from the character design positions. Okay, I'm gonna get a little real here. So in this field, I'm learning that the character design positions are very, very technical. I am awesome at being very technical. Technical meaning you are drawing someone else's creation and you are making sure you're matching the style and making everything on model and on point. That is actually my forte. I'm great. For some reason, my mind is very analytical and technical. So that stuff, I'm great at rendering and everything. So that stuff comes easy to me. And I realize the creation part is what I struggled in. So after Rick and Morty, I wanted to take a little bit of a break with that and do something that doesn't take so much mental work, so that way I can take that energy and put it into my own projects, because I noticed I wasn't doing anything creative outside of work. And I feel like as an artist, you need to take that creativity to the next level yourself. It's important to dive into what you can do and what other talents you have too. So, which comes back to me saying in the very beginning that I am an artist. I've always been an artist. I pick up on things very, very fast. I learn very quickly. And my recent struggle these past couple years in life have been, I have been yearning for more. As an artist, I am in love with so many different types of art. I love music. I play guitar and I sing, and I love performing. Growing up, I loved doing plays. I loved acting. I loved doing talent shows. Like, I have love for performing arts. And whenever I go and see like live bands or, you know, anything like that, I just like, there's a part of me that's just like, it hurts because I want to do that too. And not only that, now recently I've been getting into dance. I'm falling so much in love with dance. Like, just, it's making art with your body. And it's also staying physically fit too, in a way. And I am also in love with fitness. I had my own little fitness journey a couple years ago with the whole transformation and everything, and it has changed my life. And it has become also another hobby slash obsession of mine. So I love writing. I just like diving into all these different aspects of myself and just exploring and seeing what my capabilities are, my potentials. And I notice I feel very lost and suffocated when I can't find time, or, you know, when I can't dive into that stuff because I'm focusing all my energy just on one thing, which society has taught us. It's taught us to just focus on that one thing because that's going to be our career and our life, and that's all we have to do to make money, you know, because we have to have a job, blah, blah, blah. And it's hurting really bad because, honestly, I love drawing. I love animation. I love this industry. I'm so blessed to be a part of this industry. I met so many amazing people. It has been a dream job. And it's so great to be a part of something big, bigger than you. And it's so great to have people watch these shows and then, you know, fan out over them later and then tell you how much they love the show. And it, like, it just, especially Rick and Morty, oh my god, like, it does feel good when you tell somebody that you worked on their favorite show. Apparently it's everyone's favorite show right now. And it's a great feeling. But at the same time, having a life where, as an artist, where you do have to get up early every single day, you're basically working a 9-to-5 job, or in our field it's 10-to-7, with that lunch break. And it's a little depressing that we basically have office jobs. We are at a computer all day long. It's a digital age now. And we are at a computer all day long in an office building. And as much as they make the environment as fun as possible in this industry and as chill as possible and everything, it's just, I get cabin fever. Like, I hardly see the sun. For some reason, I get paranoid all the time to take breaks or go out for lunch because I'm always just like, I get paranoid about the amount of work I'm getting done, and I always like want to do extra, and I just don't take enough breaks for myself. And after a while, you start to go a little insane, especially when you live this monotonous life and you are constantly drawing things that aren't your creation. You are drawing other people's creation, and you're doing it for months and months on end, possibly years on end, you know, depending on how long you work on that show. And also the biggest struggle is when you are putting so much creative or mental energy or mental focus in this one area or in this one thing throughout the day, like the majority of the day, all that energy is gone at the end of the day. And since I have been big into fitness and I do have a little bit of a mental, self-esteem issues or whatever, and if I don't work out, I get depressed. I do spend the remaining hours of my day after work getting physically fit, because, you know, after sitting all day long on, you know, at a computer desk, your body does get fatigued, and when your body is not in its best shape, it does start to affect you mentally, and it's just not a good combination. So, but with that, I get sad because I don't create, I don't draw anything for myself. That's why, okay, I'm gonna go into that after, but I wanna create more for myself. I wanna actually put my creative energy into things that I, you know, enjoy drawing, get better at my skills. I want to create my own stuff for people, you know, sell my stuff, sell my name, and express myself in art and even in the physical activity stuff. I've been getting into dance recently, and that's also an art form to me. And when I'm like struggling to find time to do all of like what I love most, it sucks, because you have to live the 9-to-5 rat race system that society has created. No hate on these TV shows or jobs or whatever, and you know, these creators, but like, it's still a, you know, the full-time classic job. And yeah, so I don't want this video to get too long. This was a video introducing myself to you guys. Nice to meet you. I can't wait to explore life and arts and passions and all that stuff with you guys, with myself. My name is Sabrina Matty. If you guys want to follow my art blog, it is sabrinamatty.tumblr.com. If you want to follow me, like just in general, my personal life, visually, you can follow my Instagram. I'm very active on there. It's instagram.com/sabrinamatty. I just got a Twitter, because everybody's tweeting nowadays. You can follow me at sabrina_matty_ on Twitter. And you can watch my creations here on YouTube. Help share, like, subscribe, hit that bell button down below for notifications of when I post videos. Comment down below if you have any questions about me personally, like any personal life stories. I know I just briefed over it very fast. Not really, I rambled a lot. Comment down below if you have any questions about my career or anything you would like to tell me about yourself, if you relate to me in any sort of way, or anything motivational or whatever, I don't know. Definitely help, please help me share and get this YouTube channel out, because I do want this content to be seen, for the very reason why I'm creating this YouTube channel in the first place, is so I can eventually get a following and maybe potentially just become an independent creator myself someday, or give me the incentive to put full effort into this project. Give me incentive to work on myself more. It'll help so much. I don't know how to close this video. But for part one about me, my name is Sabrina Matty. Thank you guys so much for watching. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Happy New Year, and hope everyone's new year 2018 is going well so far. See you guys.